is News 3 Now at 10.
Good evening and thanks for having us in. As tough as it can be to schedule an appointment, it's easier for some people to get the vaccine than others. To make sure everyone gets a fair shot, the Wisconsin Department of Health Services is divvying up more than $6 million in grants to local groups working with underserved communities. Madeline O'Neill breaks down what that means here in Dane County. Maddie?
Well, we're already seeing disparities in vaccine distribution, with communities of color being vaccinated at lower rates. Health officials say they're seeing disparities in some rural settings as well. Now, more than a dozen Dane County organizations are getting some help so they can be part of the solution.
It's important so that we can all be safe.
Just as important as delivering shots.
I think it's vital.
Is delivering information.
And we know that adults with lower literacy skills are more vulnerable to COVID-19 and vaccine-related misinformation.
Jeff Burkhart runs the Literacy Network of Dane County.
We work with mostly English language learners in our programs. The information about the vaccines has been very complex, to say the least.
A $13,000 grant from the state will help them weave vaccine information into their curriculum.
Within the African American community, there are so many myths.
The African American Health Network of Dane County will use its $48,000 from the state, working with partners such as churches, to bring education and vaccines directly to community members.
You meet with us and you can be vaccinated right on the spot.
We are committed as an organization to addressing any and all disparities.
With its $100,000 grant, the SSM Health St. Mary's Foundation will think outside the box.
To get us outside the four walls of our traditional hospitals and clinics.
And get on the road with vaccines.
In a mobile van, going to different churches, maybe different restaurants.
You still gotta educate young people. Their day will come.
The Boys and Girls Club of Dane County is getting about $80,000 to do its part in getting the word out.
We're running a full campaign to try to do our best in our small role to educate kids and families in our community about the vaccine.
Now, a big part of this is trust. Many of these organizations have solid relationships with underserved communities that they serve, with people who may have some hesitancy to get vaccinated. We do have a link to a full list of all the organizations who were awarded grants and their plans on our website.
Thanks, Maddie. Well, there's a newly identified COVID variant in Wisconsin. Sauk County's health department announced it found the B1.4.27 variant, which was first found in California last summer. Meanwhile, health leaders in Rock County identified one case of the UK variant earlier this week. They say they don't know how fast the strain is spreading, but there are several things you can do to keep yourself safe.
If you're able to get vaccinated, please get vaccinated. Continue to wear your mask, especially when you're in public places, and continue social distancing, and we'll be able to hopefully prevent ongoing spread of the coronavirus and also this B117 variant.
Doctors think both the UK and California variants spread easier than the original virus. Wisconsin health officials say 517 more people have contracted COVID-19. The state has been reporting around that number for the last several days. Three more people have died. 18.5% of Wisconsin's population is fully vaccinated against COVID-19, and that's more than 1 million people. About 31% of the population has had at least one dose of the vaccine. Almost 23% of Dane County residents are fully vaccinated. That's more than 124,000 people. About 40% of the county has had at least one dose. Johnson & Johnson says it's still on track to deliver its contracted 100 million doses, and it hopes to do so by the end of May. The company delayed shipments of its vaccine from a manufacturing plant in Baltimore after a mistake spoiled about 15 million doses. Millions more doses are being tested just to make sure they weren't contaminated.
For U.S. supply, for the supply that we are anticipating through the course of May, we have been assured that that they expect to meet those deadlines.
Well, the White House continues to urge caution when it comes to relaxing social distancing measures. President Biden called out the Texas Rangers for opening their ballpark to full capacity, saying it's not responsible. The Minneapolis police chief will take the stand tomorrow in the Derek Chauvin murder trial. The prosecution showed more dramatic video today aimed at convincing the jury Chauvin's knee pressing on Floyd's neck for more than 9 minutes killed him.
It's something that we dealt with every day. You know, it's not something that just kind of comes and goes.
George Floyd's girlfriend, Courtney Ross, broke into tears as she described how they met in 2017 and recalled their struggles with opioid addiction. Ross says she and Floyd first met at a Salvation Army shelter where he had worked as a security guard. The prosecution showed never before seen video of the ambulance team arriving on the scene. Paramedic Derek Smith can be seen in this image checking Floyd's pulse.
A living person, there should be a pulse there. I did not feel one. I suspected this patient to be dead.
At the moment that you're checking for this carotid pulse, are the officers still positioned on top of Mr. Floyd?
Yes.
Also testifying today, Chauvin's own supervising sergeant, who is now retired. He said the officers should have stopped their restraint of Floyd. The prosecution also showed these disturbing images inside the ambulance as emergency responders worked frantically trying to save Floyd's life. New at 10, a man is facing OWI charges for drunken driving with kids in the car. Sun Prairie police arrested Malik Norris this afternoon. Norris was arrested by police just before 4 o'clock near the intersection of Windsor Street and Broadway Drive. Police say they got a 911 call about a man unresponsive behind the wheel of the vehicle. When officers arrived, they found Norris's two kids in the back of the car. He's in the Dane County Jail facing 4 charges, including operating while intoxicated, neglecting a child, and bail jumping. Okay, despite that sun out there, it was still a chilly day across southern Wisconsin. Dana Fulton has a look at your first warm forecast. Hey, Dana.
Hey, it's still a little chilly outside for us right now. We're in for a cold night. Temperatures today barely reaching the 40s for afternoon highs, and we started the day off in the teens. Now, my good news for you, we will not be quite as cold outside for our overnight lows and for our afternoon highs tomorrow. Looking at our Doppler track, things are nice and quiet outside. We have a clear sky overhead. Our visible cloud track showing that nice clear sky today. We did see a few clouds off to the far west and east, but nothing over southern Wisconsin. We're currently sitting close to 30 degrees in Madison, pretty close to where we were at this time yesterday for all of southern Wisconsin. Now our temperatures overnight will continue to fall into the low 20s, so again, not quite as cold outside. And tomorrow afternoon, we'll trend back closer to average with highs near 50 under a mostly sunny sky. It is going to be a little milder outside for your Friday, and the weekend even warmer. We'll take a closer look at your full 10 day in just a few minutes.
Shots fired.
Unfortunately, sometimes training didn't work.
Code 4, send an ambulance.
10-4, shot fired, need an ambulance.
Put the knives, I will shoot you. Put the knife down, put it down!
Unrealistic to remove law enforcement entirely from responding to mental health crises.
Put it down!
As it stands right now, we absolutely need more mental health officers.
In the state of Wisconsin, those wishing to become a police officer must go through 720 hours of training in an academy. Of those hours, Madison police spent 90 hours in firearms training, 75 hours in defense and arrest tactics, and 20 on mental health crisis response. In 2020, communities across the country demanded police reform with a focus on mental health response tactics. But Jamie Perez found there's a lot more to it than the numbers show.
Get down!
Is someone better equipped to handle mental health calls than the police? And the answer is yes. And the answer is everyone.
Operator, open up that door.
Everyone together is the best person to handle mental health calls. Not just the police by themselves, not just mental health workers by themselves, not just clinicians or psychologists by themselves, but everyone together.
Newly appointed Madison Police Chief Sean Barnes leads 479 commissioned officers. 6 respond to mental health crisis calls full time. 42 others are trained liaisons who can assist them when needed. And 3 journey mental health crisis workers are also available to accompany them to these calls. Sarah Henriksen is one of them.
We were to try to just
respond out to every mental health related call for service with our 6 mental health officers and 3 crisis workers, there's just no way. We would just be chasing our tails all the time.
As long as officers are involved in the response, Barnes said he wants to make sure his officers are trained for it. Starting this year, MPD officers will be required to go through what's called Integrating Communications, Assessment, and Tactics, or ICAT training, a program that Sun Prairie Police have been using for several years now. Patrol Lieutenant Ryan Cox said it's made a difference in how they respond to calls involving mental health crises.
We try to teach our people to respond and use those threat assessment factors ahead of time so that they're not putting themselves in a bad position that results in a higher level of force.
Just drop it right here, man. I can talk to you. Look, I'm 38 years old. I can relate to you, bro. There's not a thing in this world that I have not dealt with that you probably have dealt with. Okay? At the end of the day, I got kids to go home to. Appreciate it, man. I appreciate it. Just relax. Just relax. Just relax. Relax.
The DOJ is looking at standardizing this training, making it mandatory for all Wisconsin law enforcement.
We're constantly looking at standardizing the training in the state for the crisis intervention teams. And so that is definitely something that we support, and we try to provide funding when we can do that as well.
Troy Egger helps train the Janesville Police Department. He's been working on incorporating mental health crisis response training into more than just the 20 hours required by the state.
So what I'd like to do is I like to teach emotional intelligence when we are talking about mental health. Teach emotional intelligence when we're talking about firearms training and, you know, driving and all those things. Like, if you can interweave these soft skills into all the different topics, I think that's really what we have to do on an academy level.
I think 20 hours is certainly not enough for any police department.
While Wisconsin's required hours of training is actually higher than many states, according to the DOJ, Barnes knows that the 20 hours isn't working for everyone. But MPD does have required training for its officers beyond the academy level.
Do de-escalation, professional communications, scenario instruction, because all of these pieces are encompassing crisis response. We're upwards of 100 hours.
Until funding is available to provide more mental health resources statewide to prevent these types of situations from happening in the first place.
I got cuffs.
No, we don't want to hurt you.
Police say they're working on doing better for the people they serve.
Better students we're going to produce, and the less likely we're going to have issues that we see all the time.
And Cox said if more police departments get on board with doing what they can, where they can, it will result in better outcomes for everyone.
There has to be willingness on both, you know, from a professional side of the police department as well as the people that they serve. They're consumers, they're customers, right? That's who we serve. There has to be both sides that are willing to hear that and learn from it.
For News 3 Now, I'm Jamie Perez.
The Sun Prairie Police Department wants to start inviting the community to sit in on parts of their officer training as soon as next year to build trust and transparency. Madison police are looking at something similar. Chief Barnes says anyone with input or feedback should contact him directly. Stay with us when we come back. It's Prep Mania Week 2. News 3 Now sports director Zach Hanley has highlights from spring football games around the area.
Match your tax refund at A1 Furniture. Save up to 40% off. Plus, get 4 years free financing and get tax included on purchases over $4.99. Two-piece sofa and love seat or sectional, just $8.99, tax included. Match your tax refund at A1 Furniture.
Wisconsin is a home of workers. We know what needs to get done, and we do it. Yet, we've been hit hard, some harder than others. Our contact may be limited, but we still can lift each other up. Your local Wisconsin energy and emergency rental assistance providers are working together to keep you safely in your home. You may not ask for it, but we want you to know we're here to help.
For those ready to make this the year their dream yard becomes a reality, it's time to roll up your sleeves and head to Blaine's Farm and Fleet, where we have everything you need to build a backyard oasis. Like this Z-Shade Instant Canopy, $40 off, now just $79.99. Save $35 on KT Designer Welding Helmets, $64.99. Plus, stock up on workwear with men's and women's Carhartt Pocket Tees, 2 for $25.
Find value at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Step one, build a new breed. Make it an SUV. Send it off-road. Send it to the Baja 1000. Win. Then evolve, enhance, expand. Make it capable, smart, human. And then make more. Because the only way to predict the future is to build it. And the only way to build it is Ford Proud.
You expect students to make a mess in schools. But the superintendent, under Deb Kerr's leadership, the Brown Deer School District was a financial mess. Kerr's district's accounts were overdrawn by $500,000, slamming her district with late fees. And instead of firing the employee responsible, he was given paid leave, costing taxpayers $136,000 more to pay him to do nothing. Scandals, cover-ups, taxpayer money wasted. Deb Kerr, the wrong choice for state school superintendent.
Match your tax refund on a new mattress at A1 Furniture. Top brands on sale. And get tax included on any purchase over $499. Plus, get 4 years free financing with Queen Pillow Top just $349. Match your tax refund on a new mattress at A1 Furniture.
Friday morning, we'll help you get ready for Easter weekend. We'll show you how some local businesses are partnering up and donating Easter baskets.
And we'll show you how you can support local restaurants. Join us Friday for News 3 Now this morning. Chilly out on the patio right now, but we have a clear sky overnight, and that's going to lead to a clear sky tomorrow. As this high pressure overhead shifts just a little further east, we'll be on the backside of it, getting a breeze in from the south. It's going to help our temperatures climb a little more for tomorrow afternoon and for the weekend. Good news for us. As we look across the country right now, it's also a little cold for our friends in the deep south, where they have freeze warnings and watches overnight. Our threshold just a little lower to have a freeze warning issued in southern Wisconsin, although it is still going to be chilly for us as we look ahead to Friday morning. Dry and sunny weather expected for the weekend. Tomorrow will be close to average, and then for Saturday and Sunday, a little bit of a warm-up heading into Easter Sunday. Now, overnight temperatures will drop a little more in the low 20s for overnight lows. Afternoon highs will climb close to 50 degrees with a mostly sunny sky. Saturday will also be mostly sunny. We'll start the day off near 40, so not quite as cool for overnight lows. Afternoon highs will be in the mid-60s. So nice little warm-up above average for Saturday. It won't be too breezy outside. It'll be a really nice afternoon, and that trend is really going to carry us through much of the middle of April. As we look at the 6 to 10-day outlook, very likely that our temperatures will be trending above average throughout the country, and that really lines up with what we're looking at our full 10-day forecast. Yesterday and today, a little chilly, but the rest of April, or as we look ahead to the middle of April, it does seem quite likely that we are going to be in a little more mild spot. Mostly sunny skies for tomorrow. High temperatures will be near 50 degrees, so a little milder than today. In the mid-60s on Saturday with mostly sunny skies. Partly sunny skies for Easter Sunday. It will be near 70 degrees and will stay close to 70 degrees for the start of the work week. That's going to come along with a chance for some showers and isolated thunderstorms for the middle of the week. So some April showers building in. It'll cool us down a little bit behind those rain chances. We'll watch afternoon highs fall back to the mid-50s and overnight lows near 40 degrees. But still, even in the mid-50s at that point, we are above average. So again, quite a mild trend with that 10-day. We'll enjoy a few more dry days before we have the chance for any rain to build back in.
No, this isn't an April Fool's joke, and no, it's not Friday. It is, however, a special Week 2 spring football edition of Prep Mania. Sun Prairie couldn't have asked for a better stadium debut last Friday night. They shut out Verona, and they did it in dominating fashion, holding the Wildcats to 102 total yards. Up next for the Cardinal defense, a Beloit Memorial team that is still looking for their first point of the season. And this one was all Cardinals. First drive of the game, Brady Stevens with the short pass to Addison Ostrenga. And he's running a long way. 41 yards on the pitch and catch. Sun Prairie takes a 7-0 lead. And it was more of the same in their second drive. Jerry Kaminsky calls his own number and runs in for six more. Cards go up 14-0. Then on their third drive, well, you know where I'm going. Stevens sneaks it in from 2 yards out. Sun Prairie rolls 42-8, the final. Middleton opened up the year with a 22-point first quarter, including two touchdowns in a span of 36 seconds. but it's about to get a little tougher in week two against Verona. The Wildcats have beaten the Cardinals 3 out of the last 4 years. Verona debuting their brand new stadium tonight, and how about this for the first TD there? Jackson Aker breaks free, and the Badger commit is gone. He takes it 70 yards to the house. Wildcats go up 6-0. Now, they were down 10-9 in the third quarter, but then Graham Steer sneaks through the line and goes untouched to give Verona a 15-10 lead, but Middleton would score a touchdown in the fourth and go on to win 18-15, the final. Both Evansville and Monroe kicked off their seasons with impressive week one wins. The Blue Devils scored 43 points in the first half en route to a 37-point win, while the Cheesemakers put up 22 on the road. Tonight, the two high-powered offenses met, and the Blue Devils struck first in this one. First quarter, Tier Severson fakes the handoff, fakes out our camera, and then just truck sticks his way into the end zone. Blue Devils take an 8-0 lead. But Monroe would battle back with Tyler Matley. This dude can do it all. He takes the pitch, gets to the outside, and just runs right by everyone to tie the game up at 8. And Matley wasn't done. Now, they say, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Here's proof. Later in the quarter, it looks like the exact same play. Matley again finds the end zone. Cheesemakers win 40-24. Bigfoot hosting Lodi in a battle of unbeatens, and what a start to the game the Blue Devils got off to. Game's opening kickoff, and Lucas Hayroth fields it at the 10, and he has the need for speed. He's so fast he looks blue. 90 yards to the promised land. Lodi takes a 6-0 lead just seconds into the game. Bigfoot would answer later in the quarter. Basil Demko rips one to Alex Schmitz. He's in the end zone, and the game is tied at 6, but the Blue Devils break the tie in the second. Quinn Faust airs one out to Connor Faust, and the Faust-to-Faust connection puts Lodi up for good. They move to 2-0 with an 18-6 win. Stoughton bounced back after a week one loss with a 42-1 over Eau Claire North, and Wanakee shut out Fort Atkinson tonight 57-0 for Coach Rice's 300th win. Warriors moved to 2-0 on the year. New Glarus Monticello and Poinette both had similar season openers. They both gave up just 6 points apiece, and they both won big. The Pumas forced 5 turnovers, and the Knights racked up 47 points. Home opener tonight for NGM, and the Knights were ready from the start. First series of the ball game, Darius Shutt sets his feet and chucks it deep to Nathan Strife. He walks into the end zone. He's the school's all-time leading receiver, and tonight became the first to go over 100 catches in his career. Then later in the quarter, it's Shutt again, going deep. This time, he drops it in Peter Gustafson's breadbasket. Knights go up 13-0. Same score in the second, and Shutt's gonna get into the scoring act. He walks in for the score. New Glarus Monticello goes on to win 34-7. Some other scores to pass along. Benton Scales Mound, Schulzberg tops Fenimore, and Blackhawk gets their first dub of the year. They beat Southwestern 56-12. And still to come, Badger volleyball back on the court and back to dominating. How Wisconsin won its second straight Big Ten title. More sports after the break.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
We're in, we're out, we're back on the road. Let's go. Okay. Here we go. Pick them up, okay. Put them down. Get them in there, get a snack, go to the bathroom. Everybody goes to the bathroom. Make sure the cat goes to the bathroom. We are not stopping anywhere else. We used to go to the bathroom. Wait, who's that guy? When did we pick him up? All right.
Step one, build a new breed. Make it an SUV. Send it off-road. Send it to the Baja 1000. Win. Then, evolve, enhance, expand. Make it capable, smart, human. And then, make more. Because the only way to predict the future is to build it. And the only way to build it is Ford Proud.
Joe Parisi has preserved thousands of acres that the public can enjoy forever.
Joe knows we all deserve a chance to succeed.
Joe Parisi partnered with local schools to build the only school-based mental health program of its kind in the state.
Thank you, Joe, for your commitment to preserving green spaces that we can all get outside and play in.
Thank you, Joe, for working so hard to make sure everyone in this community has an opportunity and a second chance.
Thank you, Joe, for caring about the well-being of our children.
Does it really matter how beef is trimmed? Meet the facts. Fact, Hy-Vee has higher standards when it comes to trimming beef. Hy-Vee Choice Reserve is trimmed with only 1/4 inch of fat. So you pay for the meat, not for the fat. And get what you pay for. Are you getting what you pay for? Stop paying for the fat. Check out meetthefacts.hy-vee.com.
Call me devious, but you don't understand that all I am is a little mysterious.
So what do you think?
I love it.
And dozens of hits. It's the Ladies of the 80s Tour featuring Taylor Dayne, Lisa Lisa, and Evelyn Champagne King. Together live June 5th at Ho-Chunk Gaming Wisconsin Dells. Tickets are on sale now through Ticketmaster and at the Ho-Chunk Gaming Gift Shop. The red hot dance party you've been waiting for. Taylor Dayne, Lisa Lisa, and Evelyn Champagne King. June 5th at Ho-Chunk Gaming Wisconsin Dells. Your grown-up getaway.
Here you go. Thanks. Yeah, no problem.
You guys, stop yelling.
For Wisconsin volleyball, it's simple. Beat Michigan and claim their second straight Big Ten crown, but the Badgers might have to shake off some rust. Remember, it's just their second match in the last 38 days. Good news for Kelly Sheffield. Everyone was good to go tonight. First set, Badgers serving, and check out Dana Retke. She sends it right back at the Wolverines. Retke finished with 17 kills and 5 blocks. UW would win the first 2 sets, and then in the third, Devin Robinson hammers it home as the Badgers go back-to-back and claim their second straight Big Ten title with a 3-set sweep. Baseball is officially back, and the Brewers opening up the year in their newly renamed stadium, American Family Field. Third time the Crew and Twins have met on opening day, and this one lived up to the hype. Crew down 5-3 in the bottom of the ninth with 2 outs, and Travis Shaw goes shopping at the Gap. That plates 2 to tie it up at 5, and to extra innings we go, and in extras, Orlando Arcia chops one up, and Lorenzo Cain comes sliding in to beat the throw and walk it off. Brewers start 2021 at 1-0 with a 6-5 win. The hockey season may be over for the Badgers, but Cole Caulfield is still winning. The unanimous Big Ten Player of the Year and Big Ten scoring champ added another award to his trophy case today. College Hockey News tabbed UW forward its Player of the Year. Caulfield also named a Hobie Hattrick finalist. The Hobie Baker Award is announced on April 9th. We're back after this.
Rivals, you're going to be seeing a lot more of me, literally. Being named best-selling car in America for the last 19 years means there are just a lot more me's to see. So don't worry, you're not seeing double or triple. It's just me, and me again, and me again. Ciao, Camry.
Right now, you can get $1,250 customer cash on a stylish new 2021 Camry. Find yours at Toyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
There's a splash of surprise in every Wisconsin Lottery scratch game. Like
WOW, the new $10 number match game featuring a chance to win double the prize with a WOW symbol or instantly win $30 for every binocular symbol revealed. A chance to win up to 25 times and a top prize of $75,000. Instant scratch games from the Wisconsin Lottery. Odds are you'll like them.
Lighting spring sale and save 15% off everyday low prices. Every brand, every ceiling fan, every home accent. Pre-shop for low prices on visual comfort and generation brands, including Feist, Ellen DeGeneres, Ralph Lauren, Erin Lauder, and many more. Check them out on social media. Find inspiration and shop the website or shop Madison Lighting Showroom on Watts Road, Madison.
Whether you have a design emergency or you just want to shop the best furniture showroom in town, you need Dwellings. Madison's best-kept secret for design and furniture. Shop our fabulous showroom, Hard Rock Road, Fitchburg.
Join me in the 608 weekdays on News 3 Now this morning.
Well, here's the thing. It was a little chilly out, but I'm not mad about it.
No, we have the sunshine, and we're going to be back up to the 50s for tomorrow. So close to average for Friday, and the 60s on Saturday, and near 70 for Easter Sunday. We'll stay near 70 for the start of next week. So really nice weekend leads into an overall mild work week that's going to come along with some April showers and isolated thunderstorms, though. So enjoy the next few days with the sunshine.
Thanks, everyone, for spending this time with us. We appreciate it. Have a great night.